Indexes allow an object to be treated as an array. They are declared in the same way as properties, except that the this keyword is used instead of a name, and their accessors take parameters. In the example here, the indexer corresponds to an object array called data, so the type of the indexer is set to object. The getAccessor returns the specified element from the object array, and the setAccessor inserts the value into the specified element. With the indexer in place, an instance of this class can be created and used as an array, both to get and set the elements. The parameter list of an indexer is similar to that of a method, except that it must have at least one parameter, and that the ref or out modifiers are not allowed. For example, if there is a two-dimensional array, the column and row indexes can be passed as separate parameters. The index parameter does not have to be of an integer type. An object can just as well be passed as the index parameter. The getAccessor can then be used to return the index position where the passed object is located. Both of these functionalities can be provided by overloading the indexer. The type and number of arguments will then determine which indexer gets called. Keep in mind that in a real program, a range check should be included in the accessors, so as to avoid exceptions caused by trying to go beyond the length of the array.